You never had to consciously think about breathing before the asthma attack, and now you're having one, and you're trying to remember how to breathe. Your chest is constricting, and you can't get enough air. It's terrifying because you don't want to be that person that died from an asthma attack. South Shore, it's a neighborhood on the south side of Chicago, and South Shore is primarily people of color. It's a primarily Black community. Oftentimes you'll have like highways, which are really big sources of pollutants and contributors to air pollution in Black and brown neighborhoods. There's a lot of coal-fired power plants on the south side. There's a lot of industries on the south side, which not only is harming air quality, it's harming soil pollution as well. And so there's contaminated soils over there. There's contaminated air. A lot of children have asthma or other types of lung diseases because of the air they're breathing. Climate change disproportionately affects low-income and marginalized communities, such as communities of color. But the resources to mitigate those effects are not funneled into those communities. Imagine having to deal with contaminated soil where your kids can't go outside and play, and contaminated air, which you just can't avoid, and not having the resources to deal with that. And so you just continuously getting sick. It upsets me. Sometimes I feel like there's very little I can do about it. A lot of the work I do on campus is about environmental injustice, and it's upsetting because it's not as unintentional as people think. And when you're talking about solutions to environmental problems, why is it that often these voices are left out of the conversation? Why aren't there more Black and brown faces and people from the low-income communities or people living next to a coal fire plant in the conversations about solutions to climate change? Like, where are they? I would tell Illinois lawmakers to make sure that they're listening and including the communities that they're going to while switching to clean energy. I don't understand why we have to fight for clean air and clean water. We need clean air to live. It's time to take action, and we need to do something about it. One of the best ways to start is by voting. We are the next generation. We're gonna be the future politicians and scientists and activists. And so it's important for young people to go out and vote so they have their voices heard and they make a statement like, this is what I believe in, this is what I'm fighting for, and I'm not gonna support someone who is against that.